I am Dr.Uma Devi, Assistant Professor, Department of Economics. Today's topic is Concepts of Caste. Before entering deep into concepts of caste, we must know about the definition of caste. In production, research, retail and accounting, a caste is the value of money that has been used up to produce something or deliver a service. Caste is nothing but the expenditure incurred by the firm for producing one unit of output. Now let us move to types of caste. Caste are broadly divided into money caste or total cost of production, fixed caste, variable caste, opportunity caste, marginal caste, short run and long run caste, short run fixed and variable caste. Money caste or total cost of production. It refers to the total money expenses incurred by the firm in the production of a commodity, and this money cost includes cost of raw materials, wages for the laborers, expenses on machines, rent on building, interest on borrowed capital, expenses on fuel and power, expenses on transportation and advertisement, insurance charges and other all types of taxes. Next one, fixed cost. Fixed cost do not vary with the changes in output. It remains constant over a period of time. It arises because certain fixed factors are indivisible and they have to be engaged for technical reasons over a period of time. It includes rent on land or buildings, interest on capital, salaries of the government staff members, taxes, depreciation and insurance charges. Next one is variable cost. Variable cost vary with the changes in output. Variable cost are incurred by the firm is at work. It is a function of output. Total variable cost increases with the level of output and it includes cost of raw materials, cost of daily labor, cost on fuel and power, cost on hired labor and equipment, cost of repairs and other services. This diagram shows the combination of total cost, total fixed cost and total variable cost. X-axis represents the quantity of output produced and Y-axis represents the cost in rupees. And FC is the fixed cost, which is a constant over a period of time. And you can see the shape of the total cost and total variable cost in the diagram. Next is opportunity cost. It is otherwise called cost of displaced alternative. Opportunity cost of any commodity is the next best alternative commodity that is sacrificed. For example, a farmer who is producing paddy can also producing sugarcane with the same inputs. Example, he can only change the seed, that is sugarcane seed, and all the other remaining inputs are constant. Opportunity cost has a wide application in economics, applied in determining factor prices. Factor prices is nothing but we have land, labor, capital and organization as the factors of production. And for land we get rent, for labor force we get wages, capital we get interest, and for an entrepreneur we get profit. And it is used for price determination, consumption and public expenditure. Next thing is marginal cost. Marginal cost is nothing but the addition made to the total cost by producing extra unit of output, and it is symbolically denoted by marginal cost of producing n units, which is equal to total cost of producing n minus total cost of producing n minus 1 units. That is addition to the total cost of producing n units instead of n minus 1 units. And the diagram, in the diagram, x-axis represents the output and y-axis represents the price. We can show the shape of the marginal cost curve and it is U-shaped. Marginal cost can also be written as marginal cost, which is equal to change in total cost divided by change in the output produced. Marginal cost are necessarily marginal variable cost, and a change in fixed cost will leave marginal cost unaffected. We can prove with the help of a simple algebraic formula, MC of n, which is equal to TC of n minus TC of n minus 1. We can already know that total cost is the summation of total fixed cost and total variable cost. You can substitute TVN of n plus TFC of n minus TVC of n minus 1 plus TFC of n minus 1. But TFC of n, which is equal to TFC of n minus 1, which is equal to K bar, which is fixed cost to remain fixed over a period of time. And we can substitute K bar in the place of TFC of n and TFC of n minus 1. We get TFC of n minus TVC of n minus TVC of n minus 1. Hence, marginal costs are independent of the size of fixed cost. Next one, short run average variable cost. It refers to the variable cost per unit of output. Total variable cost is divided by the number of units of output produced, and it is defined as ABC, which is equal to total variable cost by Q. Q is the number of outputs produced by the firm. Next one, average total cost. Average total cost is simply called average cost, which is the total cost divided by the number of units of output produced. And the formula for calculating average total cost is total cost by number of units produced by the firm. Therefore, ATC, average total cost, which is equal to, you can, we already know that TC, which is equal to TFC plus TVC, and divided by number of units of output produced. Next thing is average fixed cost. It refers to per unit of fixed cost, and the formula for calculating average fixed cost is total fixed cost by number of units produced, that is Q, number of units of output produced by the firm. And in the diagram, it is a combination of average fixed cost, average variable cost, and average total cost. In the first diagram, you can see the shape of the average fixed cost, and the second and third diagram is the shape of the average variable cost and average total cost. Both the cost curves are U-shaped cost curves, and the fourth diagram is the combination of all the three, that is AFC, ABC, and ATC, average total cost. And next thing is short run and long run cost curves. Short run is a period of time in which only variable factors can be varied, while fixed factors remain the same. In the short run, the firm can vary its output by varying only labor force and only the raw materials. Fixed factors like capital, equipment cannot be varied. If the firm wants to increase the output only by overworking the existing plant or by hiring more number of workers and buying more raw materials. Long run cost, which refers to the period of time which is long enough to bring about possible changes in all the inputs. All fixed factors will be converted into variable factors. Here, the entrepreneur has enough time to alter all the four factors of production, that is land, labor, capital, and organization. And the firm can increase the output only by increasing the capital equipment, by increasing the size of the existing plant, or by building a new plant of a greater productive capability. And this diagram shows the long run and short run cost curves. And the long run average cost curve is the cumulative picture of all the short run average cost curve. In the diagram, x-axis represents the output and y-axis represents the cost. LAC is the long run average cost curve, and all the SAC1, SAC2, SAC3, SAC4 and SAC5 are the short run cost curves. And the shape of the long run cost curve is flattened U-shaped curve, or it is called envelope curve. Long run average cost curve depicts the lowest possible average cost of production at different levels of output, and it is called flattened U-shaped. This long run average cost curve could exist only when the state of technology remains constant, but the state of technology is subject to change in the long run. Hence, the modern firms face L-shaped average cost curve in the long run. This diagram shows the shape of the long run average cost curve. It is L-shaped, and x-axis represents the output and y-axis represents the cost.
Thank you.
Thank you, students.